It's AumSum time.
Hi guys, can you guess the title of my next video?
Oh.
Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
How tattoo removal works?
With the help of waxing strips.
No. A permanent tattoo consists of various colored particles. It can be removed with the help of lasers. Lasers emit light of different wavelengths. The colored particles absorb these wavelengths of light, get heated up, and break into smaller pieces, making it easy for immune cells to eat and excrete them out, thus removing the tattoo. Now, since every color absorbs a specific wavelength more than the other, different colors need different laser wavelengths. Black color is easiest to remove because it absorbs almost all wavelengths and breaks into smaller pieces. However, other colors like red, green, orange, blue, etc. require special lasers. Can pure oxygen kill you?
No idea.
The air we breathe has many gases, out of which 21% is oxygen. When we inhale, much of the oxygen present in air binds to the hemoglobin in red blood cell and is transported to various cells where it helps to produce energy. However, some inhaled oxygen also turns into free radicals. Free radicals are highly unstable and can be harmful. Hence, our body produces antioxidants that neutralize the free radicals. But if we inhale pure oxygen for a long time, then the number of free radicals increases. It becomes difficult for the antioxidants to neutralize them. Hence, these unstable free radicals begin to bind with proteins in red blood cells and change their chemical structure. As a result, our immune system doesn't recognize the red blood cells and begins to kill them. Besides this, free radicals even damage the DNA, which can lead to cancer.
What makes ice clear or cloudy?
At home, we generally use room temperature tap water to make ice. At room temperature, water has many dissolved minerals, gases, etc., which are invisible to our naked eyes. On freezing this water, its temperature starts dropping and ice starts to form from outside. Hence, the minerals and gases no longer remain dissolved. But, as they cannot escape out, they get pushed towards the unfrozen center. Eventually, when the center freezes, the trapped minerals and gases become visible, making ice cloudy.
Will it rain from the cloudy ice?
Oh, just listen. Now, to avoid the situation, some specialized ice makers make ice slowly layer by layer. In this technique, water is made to continuously flow over the surface of a cool container. Thus, water begins to freeze from the bottom of the container, layer by layer, giving the minerals and gases time to escape from the top, making ice clear. Topic: snoring. Why do we snore?
I don't snore. I sing.
All right. Now let me explain. Snoring is a noisy, rattling sound occurring during sleep.
Oh, really? I thought snoring is a pleasing piano sound.
Please listen. Snoring is basically caused due to obstruction of air in our respiratory tract during breathing. When we breathe, we take in air through nose or mouth, which then passes down the throat into the lungs. Normally, when we aren't asleep, our mouth parts like soft palate and uvula keep this tract wide open, allowing air to pass easily. However, excess growth of soft palate and uvula in some people causes snoring. So when these people sleep, these parts fall on the back of their throat, creating an obstruction. Hence, when they inhale, the air hits these parts, making them vibrate, which we hear as snoring. Why do cats purr?
To keep their voice melodious.
Nah. According to a popular belief, people think that cats purr when they are happy and satisfied. But did you know that cats purr in other situations also? Imagine a cat falls from a height and injures her bone. In such a situation also, the cat starts purring to heal her bones.
Purring? To heal the bones? But how's that possible?
It is found that exposure to frequencies between 20 Hz and 50 Hz builds bone density, and the frequency of a cat's purr falls within the range of 25 Hz to 150 Hz. So, it is possible that a cat who has injured her bone might be purring to build bone density and thus promote healing.
Whoa! That's awesome, dude!
In addition to this, cats also purr when they are stressed or feeling very hungry.